Transforming fantasy. It's interesting and amazing in a way that we live in this modern age where we are allowed and encouraged and invited to fantasize more than ever. You know, and we fantasize because we have this incredible industry whose sole purpose is to kind of indulge in the realms of fantasy and make-believe. And of course, this is the movie industry. You know? And that's not to say that some movies aren't based on truth and true life, of course, but they aren't. You know, they are movies and they've been scripted and put together. And it's fascinating in a way because it has human beings dreaming more than ever, possibly, you know, really dreaming of what could be and all that. And it's a habit of us. You know, we love to dream, and we dream of a better life. We dream of a better world. We dream of more money. We dream of having this. We dream of having the perfect lover. We dream all those things that we dream of inside us. And each of us has secret dreams inside our hearts. You alone know what your most secret dreams are. And if you've forgotten them, I encourage you to go within and rekindle them. And this is the realm of fantasy. And how you might think, well, how do we transform? Why would we transform fantasy? And what would we transform it into? And, you know, my answer to that is that fantasy is simply fantasy. You know, and if you are inhabiting a fantasy, there's nothing wrong with it, but you're just going round and round and round within the fantasy. And that can be very entertaining, distracting. And yet, how can we bring that, the source, the root of that dream that's in your fantasy into reality? You know, isn't that what we really want, to bring it and make it real? So what happens with us is that we tend to think that fantasy is a realm that we can't bring into reality. So we just leave it. You know, those are dreams that won't ever happen. They can't possibly happen. It's not likely to happen. You know, those things. And yet, the essence of your fantasies contains seeds that come from your soul. And they are here to be brought into manifestation and into form. Perhaps not in the exact way that your mind fantasizes, but the essence of them, the love that you feel, the joy that you may ascend into, the freedom that you might experience, those are the qualities that lie latent in fantasy. And so how do we move beyond fantasy and bring it into the world? That's what I mean by transforming fantasy. How do we bring those amazing qualities that we dream of, that we yearn for, out into our lives? How do they manifest and what might they look like? So it's really about bringing qualities alive. And so the first step really is a wonderful word, idealism. You know, you need to have an ideal at the heart of your life. Many of us don't, because we relegate our ideal to the realm of fantasy. And then we go round and round and round and round in the fantasies. If you bring the core of your fantasies out, up, higher, and you hold it as an ideal, and you live by that ideal, you shape your life around that ideal, then your life will be very different, because it will start moving in a new direction. Because a person, a man or a woman, living with a strong ideal at the core of their life is someone who's on a journey, is someone who will create things in the environment around them, someone who will have the energy and the strength to overcome obstacles. That's what the ideal does. The ideal nourishes us. What do I mean by an ideal? An ideal is like It's something hard to put into words. It's something you feel in your heart. You could paint images around it. You could, you know, you could put words around it maybe, but it's something that's beyond words. I mean, for me, the ultimate ideal is sort of something like, I want to bring joy, love, and peace to as many people as I can. You know, that's a good ideal, right? I want to transform negativity around me into positivity. You know, I want to bring people from disease into radiant health. You know, these are ideals. They're like really big, sweeping dreams, right? And you have to identify what is the flavor of your particular ideal and really dream it big. Really let it kind of become large in you. And you'll find that you have one deep inside. Everyone has one. Every single human being has an ideal. You just have to find it. And when you find it and you place it, you have the courage to place it at the core of your everyday life, then you will start living in a different way, because that ideal will start to, it'll give you the impetus to move towards it instead of just settling for second best, compromising and leaving all your ideal in the realm of fantasy. Round and round and round and round. Distraction, distraction, distraction. And nothing ever changes in your outer life. Not really. It stays on the same thing, same patterns, same mediocrity. You know, you can look at the other, you can worship your heroes, and you can look at stories that are inspiration to you and people who are leading inspirational, amazing lives, but you're not one of them. You're just one of the ordinary people. You know, and that's a sad thing. Because every human being has a genius inside them. Each one of us has an ideal. You know, and that ideal it wants to take us into this field of light. A field of light. Because that's what we are, human beings. We are a field, a living field of radiant, joyous, loving energy. That's our highest expression. We don't live that, most of us. But we need the ideal so that we have the courage to begin moving towards that dream, towards those dreams. And the magic is that once we have this ideal and we place it at the core of our lives and we start to move towards it, even just small ways, then the universe starts to respond, you know? It responds because you're living according to something, you know, a seed that was placed inside you, and you're watering it. And each day you water that seed and you give it some light, it grows a little bit more, and it grows a little bit more. And then the universe starts to kind of give you opportunities. It starts to open up new pathways ahead of you. And instead of feeling that you're trapped, the universe starts to offer you ways out, you know, ways through the difficult situation or the compromised situation that you find yourself in. You know, where you're weighed down by the heaviness of the world and the drudgery of the responsibilities that you have, or whatever it is, whatever your story is, or the disappointment that you feel because, you know, your relationships didn't work out, or the ill health that's dogging you and plaguing you. All you need is to have the courage to place this ideal that's inside your heart at the forefront of your life, you know? Pin it on your mirror. Pin it in your kitchen. Put it up there. You know, draw it, paint it. Write a poem. Capture it inside you as a feeling, as an essence. Dance it. Whatever it is, contact it. And have the guts, you know? The grit to like believe in it. And when you start believing in yourself again in that way, everything changes. I promise you, everything changes. Sometimes in small ways, you know, at the beginning. But then it builds and it builds like a snowball. You know, more and more light starts coming to you and coming through you, and more openings. And then the thing that you are really here to do starts to manifest. And it's not really about doing. That's the trick, in a way. This whole thing I'm sharing, it's not really about doing, it's about being. You start to become yourself, your true self. And the doing is, you realize, is actually, it wasn't about doing. It never was. It was never about achieving. It was about being the best, not the best at something, but being the most natural you, the most joyous you, the most relaxed you, the most authentic you. That's what your ideal helps you bring into the world. Whatever happens in your life, happening is secondary. But the being, the light at the core of your being, that is primary. So take courage, locate your ideal, place it in the core of your life, and then start to live according to that ideal. And then you won't need any of the fantasies, because it will be in your everyday reality.